Why, hello everybody, this is Eric Vierthaler 92, aka Eric the Tyrannoceratops, with how busy my schedule's been. You know, school's been really eating up all my time. This will be the only time that I'll have to make a video on this.
In a quarter mile, so, turn left onto Westwick's Lane.
Spider-Man No Way Home is rumored to have a second trailer drop sometime this month. I guess it would make sense.
At the next stop sign, turn left.
It's supposed to come out the 17th of next month, which is just days after my birthday. And, you know, just, and it's funny because it's the day after my girlfriend's birthday. So, yeah, so I guess I know what her and I will be doing for our, you know, to celebrate our birthdays. I mean, that would be a pretty cool way to celebrate it. But anyways, I'm getting off topic. So, it would make sense to release a second trailer, you know, sometime.
At the stop sign, turn left onto Westwick's Lane.
It's coming out soon before we know it. And we've only gotten one trailer. And from my understanding, that first trailer got released because it originally was leaked. Yeah, the original leaked version was a really crappy quality version. So I guess the studio saw,
in three quarters of a mile, turn right onto Lake Elmo Drive.
Release it in significantly better quality. So yeah, the big thing people are talking about is whether or not if the second trailer
at the next light, turn right,
is going to show Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield. Now, it's possible. I can't say for certain. It could go either way. That they will show Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield, and that will build up the hype that much more. Or they won't. If they don't show the trailer, if they don't show Tobey or Andrew in the second trailer, it's
at
either
the light,
for these reasons,
turn right onto Lake Elmo Drive.
Either A, because the reveal of their characters will be a big spoiler reveal in the movie, and you know, the majority of people, it'll be really hard to find somebody who feels the opposite. Most people don't like to have movies spoiled for them, and I totally understand that, because you know, it ruins the
experience.
In
1.5 miles, turn right onto Main Street.
That movie. So it would be completely understandable why, if that's the reason they don't show them in the second trailer, that would be completely understandable. Or the other reason they may not be in the trailer is because they're not in the movie. So I still am convinced that they are going to be in the movie, mostly because we have to think business-wise. We have to understand the film business is a business. They're investing millions and millions of dollars into this project. They don't want to have all that money go to waste. Especially after COVID, pretty much every business in the entire world lost a crap ton of money. So yeah, COVID left a very negative impact in pretty much every business around the entire world. They want to try to rebuild themselves after that. So business-wise, it makes sense that they would bring in Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield along with Tom Holland, because it's what people want to see. People have been saying, hey, it would be cool if we had a live-action Spider-Verse ever since when Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse came out, which I still say is the best Spider-Man movie we have ever had. A lot of people will agree. Some people will say Spider-Man 2 still is the best. I mean, Spider-Man 2 still is a good movie. But yeah, Into the Spider-Verse, by far, the best Spider-Man movie we've ever had. So it would make sense, you know, to cash in on Into the Spider-Verse, because that was a big hit. I mean, I believe that won best animated movie at the Oscars or something like that. Correct me if I'm wrong. If I'm wrong, you know, I would appreciate somebody correcting me.
At the next light, turn right.
So, a lesson we've all learned from the live-action Sonic the Hedgehog movie. Give the customer what they want. Because that original design for Sonic was not what the customer wanted. And because that was not what the customer wanted, if they would have kept the old design, the movie would have failed. But since that they changed the design and they gave the customer a much more pleasant design to look at, is what helped bring in butts into...
At the light, turn right onto Main Street.
The bottom line is, it is the, you know, you have to respect the customer because they are the ones paying to see your movie. They are the ones helping to pay to keep your business going. Similar, for an example, if I'm going to go to McDonald's and if the people who work there treat me like crap, if, you know,
in half a mile,
for example,
keep right onto 6th Avenue North.
Spits in my burger, you know? I'm not going to pay to go there anymore. Because, you know, why in the world would I, you know, after being treated poorly? So I'm totally convinced that they are in the movie. A lot of people have been saying that, you know, that leaked footage of Andrew Garfield was fake. But yeah, I know there was a video going around saying that, oh, well, this guy faked it to troll people. That video actually was refuted by actual professionals in the field of special effects. Now, I am by no means an expert in special effects myself, so that's why I have to rely on the experts, you know, what they have to say. So yeah, that video was refuted. So because of that, I don't think it's a deep fake. And when you look at Andrew Garfield's hair in it, so he's wearing the same suit he did in Amazing Spider-Man 2, but his hair doesn't match. So that's one of the things that makes me think, okay.
Use the right two lanes to keep right onto 6th Avenue North.
Oh, it was just something that I trolled people with. That video got refuted. I'm convinced that they are in the movie. If they're not in the movie,
keep right.
The movie still is going to make
in 1.9 miles.
But it's
keep
not
right
going
onto
to make
1004.
As much money if Tobey and Andrew are in the movie. And of course, they want to make as much money as they can because of all that time, effort, and money that they put into it. I know people have been saying, oh, well, Andrew Garfield and all these other people said that they're not in it. I think that they're lying about it. I think that they're lying under contract, saying that, oh, well, you can't reveal this component of the movie, and if you do reveal it, you are going to get in trouble. I believe with Star Trek Into Darkness, I believe it was called, they were saying that Khan or whoever wasn't in the movie, but then it was revealed that he actually was. So yeah, I think that they're just trying to not spoil the movie itself, because, you know, I mean, you just don't give away spoilers to movies, because like I said, it will ruin the whole experience of it. Now, of course, none of us have seen the movie yet, so we can't prove as of right now if they are or if they're not, but I think we have good reasons to think why that they are in it. Similar to how, I believe, last Christmas, my parents said that they got me something really expensive for Christmas and that I would love it. Originally, I thought that they got me a karaoke machine because, you know, my parents know that I love to do karaoke, and a karaoke machine is expensive. Now, of course, none of that proved that I did get a karaoke, none of that proved that I did get a karaoke machine.
In half a mile, keep right onto U-1004.
Good reasons to think so. Bottom line is, we're not going to know 100% for certain if they are or not until either the second trailer drops or when the movie itself comes out. If they're not in the movie, you know, I'll be disappointed, but you know, I'll still try to enjoy the movie for what it is anyway. It will be disappointing, but you know, try to appreciate what we have. You know, it just doesn't make sense to me to have the multiverse bring back all these actors from the old movies reprising their roles, like Jamie Foxx, Alfred Molina, William Dafoe, all of them, and not have Tobey and Andrew? That just doesn't make sense. You know, having the multiverse, having those other actors there reprising their old roles from the Raimi movies and the Mark Webb movies, I think that it implies that Andrew and Tobey are going to be in it. So, and especially with that reveal of the Green Goblin in the new movie, that, you know, that he has like that.
Go past green, this light, then keep, you know, right onto U-1004.
Healed over from the first movie when he got stabbed with his glider. So yeah.
Keep right.
Granted, I think that you know,
in 2.4 miles, turn, you know, left onto 19th Street West.
Goblin, I think that's official. I'm pretty sure it is. If it's not, you know, I would appreciate somebody correcting me. Because, you know, I don't want to spread misinformation. So, yeah. The video is about 12 minutes long. Just about back to my apartment. Gotta go home and study. Have an exam coming up pretty soon on Friday. So, yeah. Gotta put some studying time in. So, yeah. Those are my thoughts. What do you guys and gals think? Do you think Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield are going to be in the new Spider-Man No Way Home movie? If you do or don't, I would appreciate you letting me know why. But just please be respectful about it. And I guess that's all. You all have a fantastic day. Take care. Bye-bye, man.